Okay, welcome to all for the class on tribology, where we are dealing with the module 4, that is hydrostatic bearings. We have seen in the previous sessions, that is that what is an hydrostatic bearing and what are the difference between hydrostatic and an hydrodynamic. Then we derived an expression for load carrying capacity for an hydrostatic bearing and discharge or a flow rate through an hydrostatic step bearing. After completion of all the derivations, we started with the problems. So we have only the problems on load carrying capacity, flow rate and power loss due to viscous friction, in an hydrostatic bearing. So today we will continue with our problem. So continue with problem 2. The problem states like this. The following are the data for an hydrostatic step bearing. So here I am dictating the problem to you. Whenever you listen to this video, please write down the problem statement properly, because in the problem you will be given with much enough data to solve this problem. This problem will be appearing in the examination for 10 marks. So you have only the substitution work that is left out for you, because the equations are given in the data handbook that we have provided for this tribology course. Okay, so we will start with the problem. The problem statement goes like this. The following are the data for hydrostatic step bearing. The shaft speed 700 rpm, shaft speed 700 rpm, diameter of the shaft 500 mm, recess diameter 300 mm, minimum film thickness 0.15 mm, The viscosity of the lubricating oil, is 30 centipoise. The supply pressure of the bearing, is 5 megapascal. Full stop. Calculate. The first sub-question, calculate the load carrying capacity of the bearing. The second sub-question, oil flow rate of the bearing. Third sub-question, power loss due to viscous friction. I will repeat the problem once again. The following data refers to an hydrostatic step bearing. The shaft speed equals 700 rpm, shaft diameter 500 mm, recess diameter 300 mm, minimum film thickness 0.15 mm, viscosity of the lubricating oil 30 centipoise, the supply pressure of the lubricant or supply pressure of the lubricating oil is 5 megapascal, full stop. Calculate the load carrying capacity of the hydrostatic bearing. Second sub question, flow rate of the bearing. Third sub question, power loss due to viscous friction. So this is the problem given to us. So let us write down all the given data in the problem, and the data mentioned in the problem, as I have gone through the problem, it's the values that are mentioned in the statement is in terms of millimeters. The units of those values are in terms of millimeters. So we can retain the units in terms of millimeters, or we can convert that millimeter to meters. So that we can do while just writing down the data itself into when we start with our solution. So looking into the problem statement, so we have the first data given to us. We have the first data given to us is the shaft speed. shaft speed is 700 RPM, we want this speed, we also want this speed to be in terms of RPS. RPS means revolutions per second. So in the statement, they have given revolutions per minute. How to convert RPM to RPS? Just divide the value by 60. Divide the value by 60. 700 by 60. I will be getting it as 11.666. 11.67 RPS. 11.67 RPS. Observe, for RPM, the speed in RPM, the notation used is N, small letter N. For RPS, I am using N dash. I have retained N, which is in terms of RPM. If you just put a dash, it gives in terms of RPS. Shaft diameter D2, that is D2, is 500 mm. So I want this in terms of meters. So 500 into 10 power minus 3 meter. 500 into 10 power minus 3 meter, or you can just write it as 0.5 meters also. 500 into 10 power minus 3, or it is nothing but 0.5 meters. Same way, diameter D1, 0.3 meters. Minimum film thickness, H. The minimum film thickness, the notation for minimum film thickness is H. H, 0.15 millimeters they have given. We change that to 0.15 into 10 power minus 3 meters. Viscosity of the lubricating oil is 30 centipoise. 30 centipoise. The other unit for centipoise is Pascal second. Let us have this centipoise in terms of Pascal seconds. I write that as 30 into 10 power minus 3 Pascal second. Then P naught, that is supply pressure. P is the pressure and naught represents supply pressure. P naught represents the supply pressure, 5 megapascal. 5 into 10 power 6 newton per meter square. Newton per meter square. These are the datas given in the problem. These are the datas that are given in the problem. With these datas, we need to solve the problem. So they have also specified what are the things to be found, what we need to find. Calculate the load carrying capacity. The load carrying capacity is denoted with W. The flow rate is denoted with Q. Power loss due to viscous friction is denoted with P for power loss, mu due to friction. So these are the unknowns that we need to find out. So what is an expression for load carrying capacity? We need not mug up for that expression, or we need not by add those expressions. So we have a data handbook for this course, that is tribology. So this, for hydrostatic bearing, we have the datas given in page number 23.67 of our data handbook. Page number 23.67, where we have hydrostatic bearing, that is step bearing. Under that heading, we have been given with P naught, that is pressure in the pocket supplied from external source to the support, to support the load. P naught equals 8W natural log D2 by D1 divided by pi D2 square minus D1 square. That is equation number 23.142A. This is what we have derived while deriving the load carrying capacity. Then we have an expression for load carrying capacity directly. W equals pi P naught D2 square minus D1 square divided by 8 natural log D2 by D1. That is 23.143. It's in the same date page number. Then we have rate of flow of lubricant through the bearing. It is Q equals pi P naught H cube. They have given 2 neta. It is not 2 neta. Please make a note, make a correction over there. It is 6 neta. 6 neta. There is a printing mistake, typing mistake present in that equation. The denominator is not 2 neta, it should be 6 neta. Natural log D2 by D1, that is 23.144. Then for power loss in the bearing, it is given to us as 0.06 to N dash square neta divided by 16 times of H, whole thing into D2 to the power of 4 minus D1 to the power of 4. So we have all the equations specified in the data handbook. So our duty is to pick up the equations from the data handbook according to our problem and find the unknowns, what is required for completion of this problem. So as the problem says, we'll start with load carrying capacity. That is W. For load carrying capacity, please turn the data handbook to page number 23.67. Refer equation number 23.143. We have pi P0 D2 square minus D1 square, D2 square divided by D1 square, whole thing divided by 8 natural log D2 divided by D1. 8 natural log D2 divided by D1. So this is equation number 23.143, page number 23.67. Page number 23.67. So please observe the data in the terminologies present in this equation and check up with the data given in the problem. So we know P0, 5 megapascal, D2 and D1 are given, and the rest is just a simplification, mathematical simplification using the calculator. So I will substitute now. Pi 5 into 10 power 6, mega means it is 10 power 6, D2 is 0.5 square minus 0.3 square. D1 is 0.3 meters, D2 is 0.5, so 0.5 square minus 0.3 square, whole thing divided by 8 natural log 0.5 divided by 0.3. So let us use our calculator to solve this. Pi into 5 to the power of 6 into 0.5 square minus 0.3 square. The numerator, what I am getting is 2.513 into 10 power 6. Natural log 0.5 divided by 0.3 into 8. The denominator is 4.086. We got it as 614.93 into 10 power 3 Newton, or we can just write kilonewtons. So the load carrying capacity is done. The second unknown, oil flow rate Q. So let us refer our data handbook to get an expression for Q. So the Q, pi P0 H cube divided by 6 neta natural log of D2 by D1. So this is equation number 23.144, page number 23.67. So again, we have all the values of the equation. Let's substitute them. Pi 5 into 10 power 6, 0.15 into 10 power minus 3 cube, whole thing divided by 6. The viscosity is 30 into 10 power minus 3, natural log 0.5 divided by 0.3. Again, let us simplify them. The numerator, we have got it as 5.30 into 10 power minus 5, whole thing divided by 0.0919. So the flow rate, we get it as 5.76 into 10 power minus 4 meter cube per second. So we obtained the value of flow rate also. Now what is the third unknown? What we have? The last one is power loss due to viscous power loss due to viscous friction, that is P mu. Let us refer the data handbook to get this value. Please go to equation number 23.145A, page number 23.67. So P mu equals n dash square into neta, whole thing into d2 to the power of 4 minus d1 to the power of 4 divided by 16 times of h. Equation number 23.145a, page number 23.67. Again, we know all the values. All the values of this equation. Shall we substitute them? Okay. 0.062 into neta. Sorry, n dash. N dash is 11.67. That is square. Neta, 30 into 10 power minus 3, whole thing divided by 16, minimum film thickness is 0.15 into 10 power minus 3. Why it is 10 power minus 3? Because we are converting millimeters to meters. D to the power of 4, 0.5 to the power of 4, minus 0.3 to the power of 4. On calculation, we get P mu, that is power loss due to friction, as, let us calculate them. So when you are watching the video and writing down the things, please use the calculator to find out the values, or else you will just mug up the things or just watch the video as a movie, and you won't get when you are actually solving in the examination. So we got power loss as 5.741 kilowatts. This is the completion of this problem. See, what the problem was very simple, where we have used all the data specified in the problem, and the equations are available in the data and book, and we have just substituted those values and calculated with the help of our calculator. That's all. Can't we solve this problem? Each sub question carries 3 marks, and conversion of those values will be given for 1 mark. So this is how we will be solving the problem. I hope it is clear. Shall we move on to the next problem now? So let us continue with our next problem. That is the problem. So I will start the statement of the problem. A hydrostatic step bearing has the following characteristics. A hydrostatic step bearing has the following characteristics. The diameter of the shaft, 93.75 mm. Diameter of the shaft, 93.75 mm, comma. Diameter of the pocket, 62.5 mm, comma. The shaft speed is 600 rpm. The shaft speed is 600 rpm, comma. The external supply, externally pressurized fluid with a pressure of 5 megapascal, or external pressure equals 5 megapascal. The supply pressure is 5 megapascal, comma, the external pressure is 0, or atmospheric pressure, comma, the oil flow rate within the bearing is 390625. Oil flow rate within the bearing is 390625 millimeter cube per second, and minimum film thickness or minimum oil film thickness is 0.125 mm. Calculate the viscosity of the lubricating oil under the given operating conditions. Viscosity of the lubricating oil under the given operating conditions. Second sub question, the load carrying capacity of the bearing. The third sub question, power loss due to viscous friction. I will repeat the question once again. The following is the characteristics of an hydrostatic step bearing. Diameter of the shaft, 93.75 mm. Diameter of the pocket, 62.5 mm. And the running speed of the shaft is 600 rpm, comma. Oil supply pressure is 5 megapascal, comma, external pressure equals 0, or atmospheric pressure. The rate of oil flow through the bearing is 390625 millimeter cube per second, and oil film thickness is 0.125 mm. Calculate the viscosity of the lubricating oil under the given operating conditions. Second sub question, load carrying capacity of the bearing. Third sub question, power loss due to viscous friction. So we have noted down the given data, and let us convert them according to our convenience. Like, their majority of the terms are given in terms of millimeters. Let us take them into meters. Let us convert them into meters. We have RPM, speed in RPM. Let us convert that into RPS. So 600 RPM, when converted into RPS, it becomes 10 RPS. So 93.75 into 10 power minus 3 meter 62.5 into 10 power minus 3 meters, 0.125 into 10 power minus 3 meters is the minimum oil film thickness. The rate of oil flow Q is given in terms of millimeter cube per second. So for 1 meter, it is for 1 meter equals 1000 millimeter. So I want to convert millimeter cube to meter cube. So it will be 390625 into 10 power minus 9 meter cube per second. P naught becomes 5 into 10 power 6 Newton per meter square, and the external pressure is 0. External pressure is 0. And the unknowns they have asked is the viscosity, neta, load carrying capacity, W, and the power loss due to friction is P mu. Power loss due to friction is P mu. So we need to analyze the problem, understand the statements, and we should start. And the equations are present in page number 23.67. The basic three equations, that is for pressure, flow rate, power loss, and load carrying capacity. So observe the problem statement. In the problem statement, we are given with the flow rate Q. We have an expression for flow rate Q. With that flow rate, we have an equation as Q equals pi P naught H cube divided by 6 neta natural log of D2 by D1, natural log of D2 by D1. The only unknown in this equation is neta. So can we just cross multiply, modify this equation according to our requirement, and can we get the unknown? Yes, let us go with it. So the first one, to find the viscosity, I will be using an expression for flow rate Q, pi P naught H cube divided by 6 neta natural log of D2 by D1. Equation number 23.144, page number 23.67. Observe, in the problem they have given Q, pressure is known, film thickness is known, the diameters are unknown to us. So what the only unknown is the viscosity. I just cross multiply that, neta pi P naught H cube divided by 6 Q natural log D2 by D1. These are the values. So can we find the value of neta? Yes. I will substitute now, pi, 5 into 10 power 6, the value of H is 0.125 into 10 power minus 3 H cube divided by 6 into 390625 into 10 power minus 9 natural log. Since it is a fraction, or since it is the division, so I will be using directly the millimeters, because millimeter by millimeters, it becomes a dimensionless value. So it becomes easy for me while using the calculator to get the answer. So neta, let us find out the terms now. Pi, 5, E6. The numerator, I've got it as 3.0679 into 10 power minus 5 divided by it is 0.0322 Pascal seconds. Or we can write that as 1, 2, 3. 32.2 × 10⁻³ Pascal second. Or Neta equals 32 CP, 32 centipoise. Now observe, we found the value of the viscosity of the lubricating oil. The second unknown asked in the problem is load carrying capacity. So the equation for us is 23.143, the load. Load carrying capacity, W equals pi P naught D2² - D1² divided by 8 natural log of D2 by D1, natural log of D2 by D1. This is equation number 23.143, page number 23.67. Observe, can you find the load carrying capacity now? Yes, we know the pressure, we know the diameters, and we can start calculating the load carrying capacity. Pi P naught 5 × 10⁶ D2 93.75 × 10⁻³ square minus 62.5 × 10⁻³ square whole thing divided by 8 times natural log of 93.75 divided by 62.5. you may ask, sir, in the numerator you are substituted in terms of millimeters, meters. In the denominator you used natural log of millimeters per millimeters. Since it is the division, so the unit doesn't matter over there. So I have kept as it is, so that it will be helpful for us while substituting in our calculator. So let us see what we get. We get it as 23.645 × 10³ newtons, or we can write that as 23.645 kilonewtons. We can just write in terms of kilonewton. So the last unknown power loss P mu 0.062 n′² neta into d⁴ - d₁⁴ divided by 16 H. Divided by 16 H, equation number 23.145A, page number 23.67. The equations are present on the same page of that is page number 23.67. Okay, so let us substitute 0.062 × 10² into 10 square into 32.2 into 10 power minus 3 93.75 into 10 power minus 3 to the power of 4 minus 62.5 into 10 power minus 3 to the power of 4 whole thing divided by 16 into 0.125 into 10 power minus 3. So let us calculate this. (0.75 - 3)/4 - 0.5 × 32.2 × 3 × 0.062 × 10². So we get a value 1.2375 × 10⁻⁵ / 16 × 0.125 × 3. We get it as 6.1875 × 10⁻³ kW. This is the solution to the problem. Observe, in the two problems that we have solved today, so the almost the statements are same, but they have changed the datas and they have asked to find out the unknowns. For example, in the previous problem, the problem was direct. We solved load carrying capacity, flow rate and the power loss. But here, they had given the flow rate and they asked us to find the viscosity and load carrying capacity and so on. In the next problem, they may give the viscosity, flow rate, but they may not mention the pressure, and they will ask us to determine the supply pressure. Or even they specify the supply pressure and they may ask us to find the minimum film thickness. So the problems will go like this. So we will be using the same three equations, but the unknowns might be different. The unknown might be the supply pressure, viscosity, or the film thickness, or the diameter of the shaft or the recess, and so on. We have only minimum unknowns: flow rate, pressure, minimum film thickness, viscosity, diameter of the recess as well as the shaft. So in the next coming class, we will see few more problems, and we will wind up this module for. Thank you.